Myself, Ms. Shailaja Dyawarkonda, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department. In today's lecture, I am going to tell about the projectile. At the end of this lecture, students will be able to analyze the projection of particles in horizontal and vertical direction, and the students will be able to analyze inclined projection on leveled ground. Projectile. It is observed that the particle moves along the curved path if it is freely projected in air in the direction other than vertical. It means whenever you throw a particle upward, it may be, we assume that it is vertical, but in actual it is not vertical. It has two directions, that is, other than vertical means one direction is vertical and second one is horizontal. The freely projected particles which are having combined effect of vertical and horizontal motion, it is called as projectile. These are the common terms used in the projectile. So here in this figure, this particle U is thrown upward to the ground. So it is inclined to the surface. So it has two directions, that is horizontal as well as vertical direction. So these are some common terms used in the projectile. Velocity of projectile. The velocity with which the particle is projected is known as velocity of projection. It measures in meter per second. It means with which velocity you are throwing the particle is called as velocity of projection. Angle of projection. It is the angle between the direction of projection and the horizontal surface. Trajectory. The path traced by the projectile is called its trajectory. It means when you throw the particle U upward, when it will reach the ground, it will may have traveled some path. It is called as trajectory, and it is a curved path. Horizontal range. The distance traveled by this particle U from starting point to the point at which it touches the ground or it will reach the ground is called as horizontal range. So it is the horizontal distance through which the projectile travels in its flight is called as horizontal range. Flight means the distance or the point of starting of particle and the point when the particle reach the ground level. This plane is called as flight. Time of flight. The time interval during which the projectile is in motion is called time of flight. It means when I throw this particle U upward with velocity, when it will reach the ground level, whatever time is required from point A to travel this last means whenever it is reach the ground level, the time required for to cover this distance is called as time of flight. Now in this lecture we are going to study about inclined projection on leveled ground. Consider in this figure the particle is thrown with velocity u. So it is the inclined in plane, so it has two directions, that is x and y, means vertical and horizontal direction. C is the maximum height that particle travels upward and after which it will be coming to the ground level. And this particle is thrown with the leveled ground surface. Here the vertical motion means the initial velocity of this particle is u sin alpha, because initial velocity is u and it is having the horizontal angle alpha with the horizontal axis. Next one, acceleration. Acceleration is a is equal to minus g, means it is acting downward, so it is taken as negative, so meter per second square. Then horizontal component of velocity. The horizontal component of velocity is given by initial velocity and the angle between horizontal axis, that is u cos alpha. Here vertical motion means it is the angle with the horizontal axis, and the horizontal component is angle with the horizontal axis. So here in initial velocity we have considered u sin alpha, and in horizontal component it is u cos alpha. Equation of trajectory. Equation of trajectory is given by y is equal to x tan alpha minus 1/2 into x square by u square plus, sorry, into 1 tan square alpha. This is the equation which will created or which will derived from this maximum height of the particle at which it will reach, and afterwards it will come through the ground surface. The maximum height is calculated by x square sin square alpha upon 2g. G is nothing but the gravitational acceleration. Time required to reach maximum height. To reach this maximum height, how much time you will require, that will be calculated by using the formula t is equal to u sin alpha upon g. Then time of flight. Time of flight is calculated by t is equal to 2 u sin alpha by g. And the horizontal range of the projectile is calculated by the formula u square sin 2 alpha upon g. Here g is the gravitational acceleration and u is initial velocity of the particle. Now by using a single problem I will explain. A projectile is aimed at a target on the horizontal plane and falls 12 meters short when the angle of projection is 15 degrees, while it overshoots by 24 meters when the angle is 45 degrees. Find the angle of projection to hit the target. In this figure, one particle is thrown. In first case, it is traveled distance 12 meters. In second case, it is traveled distance s, and in third case, it is traveled distance 24. Here, you have to calculate the distance of the projectile which will it have traveled. Here we will consider the initial velocity u as shown in figure. Now as shown in figure, the range of projection is given by the expression, means horizontal distance of the projectile is given by r is equal to u square sin 2 alpha g. We will apply this equation for the first case. First case means the particle is traveled up to 12 meter. So we don't know the exact distance, so we have considered it as a s. So this first distance will be s minus 12. Now applying this first case, that is r is equal to s minus 12 and u square g into sin 2 alpha. Here u is the initial velocity and alpha is given as 15 degree for the first case. Then from second case, the particle moves up to 24 meter. So here we will consider the range of the particle or horizontal distance is s plus 24 is equal to u square upon g sin 2 alpha. So for second case, the angle is given as 45 degree. So by solving these two equations, you will get the actual distance of the projectile, that is 48 meter. Let the correct angle of projection be alpha. Then you have to calculate the angle of the projection. So you know actual range of or horizontal distance of the projectile. So by using the same formula, r is equal to u square upon 2 sin 2 alpha upon g, you can calculate the alpha. So here from this equation, it is horizontal range, it is u square by g is equal to s plus 24, so it is total 72 meter. So by using the formula, it is 48 is equal to 72 sin alpha. So the inclination of projectile is 20 degree. at the 20 degree with the horizontal surface. Now by using these formulas and by using all these formulas, we have to calculate the distance alpha or the maximum height of the projectile. So these are some references carried for this lecture. Thank you.